kick off show today.
Dig it.
So please give us a like and a share. And if you have a comment, please put your comment in, because we will definitely be taking your comments and reading about them all throughout the show. We appreciate you watching and listening. And please patronize our sponsors, because that's what brings us to this point today.
The comments can be lewd or slightly off color, even not family friendly. Doesn't mean we're going to read them on the air, but we are looking. There are extra points for creativity. So
let's
see what you've got.
We do have some giveaways today as well. I should maybe start out with that, but let's say good morning real quickly. I'll tell you about that in a second. Let's say good morning to Mark Grimsley, Tim Berg, and Jim Wiebe. Hey, Mark. Morning, peeps. Mark is always great for early morning. Gina for president. Jim Wiebe. Ugh, you don't want to go there, Jim. Tim Berg says, good morning, Gina Woods. It's a beautiful morning in Copperopolis. Good morning to you. David Schumann joined. Good morning, David. And they
David.
Are also our title sponsors. They are the motorcycle safety lawyers.
They are.
And we're going to talk more about that in a little bit. We've got Paul Manick is joining in. Damon, good morning. Good morning, Jeff Lyons. Hey, Jeff, Scott.
Jeff.
Scott, I saw your silly bonfire post last night. Patrick Michael. Gosh, I don't know where he's in, like Spain or something. He's always traveling the world. Bob Williams, good morning. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Hey, let's just jump right into the show. We want to talk with Marilyn and find out what the status. Everybody has rescheduled or canceled. We know this. Mm-hmm. Laconia has. I think everybody's waited to the last minute.
Sure.
We know our local Motoblot has.
Indeed.
They're in sometime in late September. Thank God for the people that are still holding out and can, but a lot can't.
Sure.
Vendors and so forth. We talked with Jerry Cole a couple weeks ago on Open Road Radio, and so happy that it's still, Sturgis is on.
Sturgis is
still
on.
And Marilyn can tell us more about it. Marilyn, good morning.
Hi there. How's everybody today?
Very well. Very
Everybody's
well.
Everybody's good. Just dying to get out from under all of this. You know, I'm spending too much money. I've got so many home projects. I'm seriously going to be broke by the time this is all over. I really am, because
it's not the only one, that's for sure.
Usually. I'm out and about.
Yeah. I, on the other hand, am not spending much at all. I don't go to restaurants. I don't go to bars. I don't go to concerts.
I'm saving there, but I'm spending more at my house, which does cost more, I think. I hate it. I'm telling you. I got painters there today. I'm like, oh, my God.
I'm excited to talk about Sturgis. I'm actually headed there Thursday morning. I'm riding out there.
You are?
Yeah, for a week. I've got a cabin. I think, what is it? Crescent City.
Hey,
Capital
come
City.
Over and see us. Come on. We can sit out on the deck outside properly, socially distanced, and catch up.
That's a great idea.
So what you're saying is we won't be making out or anything.
Right. Oh, well, I don't know. I don't want to rule anything out.
The day is still light. Early.
The day is early.
The day's still early, baby.
I love riding up through there. I think it's some of the most beautiful riding in the country, if not the world. And it's a different experience going there when it's not the rally and you're just there to kind of take in the sights.
One of the reasons people keep coming back is because it's such a beautiful place to ride, and you know, it hasn't changed. And you know, like Myrtle Beach this week, people are going to come and ride in the Black Hills, whether someone says there's a rally or not.
That's the point. That's a big point. That's we discussed that about a month ago when we were discussing the status of different events and different rallies. And the fact of the matter is the planners of Sturgis have to be in line, because even if they said we're not doing anything, people are going to show up anyways, and that's even more of a complication. So something,
it's okay with us, because you know, no one really owns the Sturgis rally. It's not like there's one organization that
I do
says
it's mine
fantastic, we'll postpone it. It's still America, land of the free, home of the brave. If you want to ride your motorcycle, you can ride it wherever you want.
I want to ride a buffalo. I want to ride a buffalo. Outside of the Badlands once, just by the entrance, there were a couple of buffalo just sitting there, and I tried to leapfrog over one.
You tried to mount one?
Yeah, it didn't work. It just, yeah.
Don't. But I have to tell you, there's someone here who knows a whole lot more about what's happening in Sturgis. Should we bring on this special guest?
Yes.
Oh, my God. I'm tingling.
Who could it be?
Wait. Properly socially distant.
We need a drum roll. Woody Woodruff, Rod Woodruff, joins us live from Buffalo Chip. Rod, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for joining us.
Well, thanks for letting me on.
Did we really have a choice?
Great conversation and your show, so that's great. So don't let me hog anything up, but you know, we agree with.
I love that.
Marilyn says, of course, is absolutely correct. You know, so Buffalo Chip's having a motorcycle rally, no matter what happens elsewhere. So that's kind of what we keep doing here is just getting ready.
Good. So glad to hear it. What do you think? When would you hear if? What would you tell people to stay on course, keep your plans? You know, people do Sturgis, unlike, I don't know, any motorcycle rally, I think, in the world. They plan it years before, sometimes 5 years before, sure. 10 years before, especially for something like the 80th.
Yes.
You know, that's a monumental year for them. So what would you tell people to stay on course?
Drink heavily. I'm sorry.
Everybody needs to make up their own mind. And I kind of had a thing ever since I can remember, maybe childhood, you know, I just hate to be told I can't do something.
I think you and I have a similar friend by the name of John Galt.
You know, we're going to be here. We're going to have a really good time. We've got, great programs, great shows going on. It's going to be a cool time.
Yeah, and let me add, you know, I know you're talking about motorcycle history, and of course there's some history with the 80th happening, but also the 39th year of the Buffalo Chip, which is a pretty big deal. And Motorcycles as Art this year has an amazing framework of historic legacy builders. So the Smith and Norland Fatland and Eddie Trott and Billy Lane and all the big names from motorcycle customizing history.
Well, and actually, it's an extra special deal, too, because, you know, this is the 20th year that Michael has curated a show. It's the 12th year he's been here, but it's 20 years he has been doing a show. And it's 40 years since he started coming to Sturgis and taking photographs. And I think anybody that's ever seen a motorcycle has also seen
Michael Lichter's
anyway that Michael Lichter has taken that is just iconic, and it just has defined the motorcycle lifestyle.
You know what? I got to tell you, one of my favorite events, and you know, you plan the events, especially when you're in the motorcycle media, around the other, around some of the big events for media,
sure.
And then for the consumers, of course, and motorcyclists. But yeah, one of my favorite events of all, and it's like right out the gate, you know, the first weekend typically. So I a lot of fun. And something very memorable, and then it's kind of like old homeschool week because you get to see everybody.
Well,
so
cancel it if you said you weren't coming.
What?
Yeah.
No, I'll be there.
Party if Gina's not there.
Absolutely.
What is the status, if you know, with regards to the different bands that have been slated to perform?
Good question.
Some of the other events, you know, that take place all around the area. Is it being scaled back? Is it everything full go? What's the story? Morning Glory.
You know, the truth of the matter is there's going to be some kind of restriction, I suspect, imposed by the state at the, you know, like you were talking about earlier. Some of that stuff's going to come at the last minute. And so, you know, we're here as a campground. We got plenty of space for people to be socially distancing. And we're just planning to go straight on ahead. And so I think a lot of our people have been as well. We had a tremendous number of reservations for people coming, and we just have had nobody call up and say, hey, I ain't coming. So,
well, you know what? I mean, we talked to
the nicest people from New Zealand, Australia, and the European countries that say, geez, they won't let us out of the country. We can't even come. So,
yeah.
Other than that, you know, we're on. And so
we'll smuggle them in. That's a new business. We're going
to
smuggle in international tourists who want to go to Sturgis.
We'll put them in a motorcycle.
We'll put them in a big box. We'll send them DHL. Never say die.
I think that's a great idea. But, you know, Rod, I mean, this could go one or two ways. Either it could be cut back slightly, or it's just going to be a blowout because people have not gone anywhere, because people have saved money And Sturgis won't be able to keep up with all the people that want to come
sure.
and visit.
And let's call a spade a spade. Sturgis is so much fun, it's worth getting sick. Okay, so
new slogan.
I mean, the fact of the matter is after a week at Sturgis, you're pretty much down for the count for at least the following 2 weeks anyway.
For
so,
sure.
I mean, it's six of one, half dozen of the other.
And honestly, guys, I think this is the Sturgis rally you do not want to miss.
Yeah.
It's so unusual. It's going to be one like we've never seen before. And it really could throw us back to the roots of where this thing came from, you know, where it was more grassroots, less corporate, just people were out in the pasture having a party. Because, you know, you couldn't do anything else and you were dying to go hang out with your buds and ride your bike.
It was mine. Stop that.
I can't hear anything.
He just blasted my eardrums out. Hang on, hang on. That's awesome. And so, guys, how do you want to tell people to keep tabs on coming to Sturgis? You know, where should they go to get the most updated information?
Well, the most updated information everybody gets from everywhere, actually. But we're trying to keep people advised. We put out a little video with anything significant that is changing about the rally. That's on our website on the Facebook thing for Buffalo Chips. So people could certainly go there and catch that. And I think programs like yours, you know, is a regular update as well. But really, all these people that just don't like to be told no, I think they're planning on coming. we're looking forward to seeing them again.
Man, I don't know if Sturgis can contain that.
Those are three words you can't say to me. No, don't, or stop, because I'm going to do it unless you say them to me all at the same time. No, don't, stop.
Baby?
Then I'm going to keep going. Then I got to keep going.
Baby. Okay. Hey guys, thank you so much for joining us. If you want to hang in the wings for a few minutes, we're going to bring up our friends from the National Motorcycle Museum, Joe Parham and Bill Barber. But first, we are going to run to a commercial break. So thank you so much. Woody, get back there. Woody, thank you. Thank you for joining us, darling. I know you're a busy guy.
Thank you, Woody. Marilyn.
Can't wait to see what Buffalo Chip's going to come up with this year, because they always come up with a lot of
I'm entering the wet t-shirt contest, hands down.
Dear.
That's right.
All right, guys. Thank you so much, Woody. All right, guys. We're going to run to a break real fast. We're going to come back. We're going to go to the phone lines. We've got a lot of people on Bodine from Florida. I love when you check in. Hey, Les, thank you so much. Sure. I got that lock fixed. Cortez, I agree with Joel.
I like everything. You, Cortez. I don't know who you are, but you're my new best friend.
All right, guys, stay tuned. We're going to be right back after these messages.
Thank you.
Motorcycle accident? The experienced motorcycle accident lawyers will set your mind at ease so you can recover while they fight for your best possible outcome. Mark J. Schumann and Associates has over 30 years in personal injury and motorcycle accident representation and wins. Contact Mark J. Schumann and Associates at 833-IL-CYCLE. That's 833-IL-CYCLE. The Motorcycle Safety Lawyers or MotorcycleSafetyLawyers.com, and speak directly with Mark about a free review of your insurance policy. No gimmicks, no scams, a free review. Sign up today for free to win a 2020 FXDR Harley-Davidson or $20,000 towards the motorcycle of your choice. And while you're there, you can also sign up for accident scene management classes, sponsored by Mark J. Schumann and Associates. Mark J. Schumann and Associates at 833-IL-CYCLE, the Motorcycle Safety Lawyers.
Tired of aspirins, Tylenols, and ibuprofens for aches and pains? For the past 20 years, Chicago CBD and essential oils owner David Sachs has been involved in the specialty foods market, and seeing his customers' health challenges, his business has further evolved into providing direct wellness solutions. Bringing together a collection of the finest natural products from the hemp, essential oil, and honey worlds, David developed high-impact solutions people can benefit from. CBD isolate drops, sublingual, and broad-spectrum CBD and non-CBD raw honeys and bee products. Extra strength with CBD pain creams, CBD bath products including shampoo, conditioner, Epsom salts, and bath bombs, and therapeutic-grade essential oils. There's even CBD coffees, edibles like gummies and honey, and even CBD bacon-flavored pet drops for your pups. Check out CBD bundles for additional savings by ordering online today at MyChicagoCBD.com. Use promo code OpenRoad15 for 15% off your order. And as David says, be well, stay well.
All right, and we are back. And I just want to say a couple of things. We've got some sponsors that we would all like for you to patronize. Go check out their websites, order from them. Our friends at J&P Cycles, SchumannLegal.com, MotorcycleSafetyLawyers.com, Motoblad, MyChicagoCBD. Man, I've been bringing that stuff in, and everybody's been using it in the studio. It's this lotion. It's great. It's great, great stuff. It's great for my kicker knee. It's really great stuff. Megwear.com, Greg Allen Haggerty Insurance, Haggerty Insurance, and the licorice guy. Had a lot of people that ordered the licorice stuff as well. So, hey, let's go to the phone lines. We've got a surprise guest before we go to the National Motorcycle Museum. And hello, you're on the air with Open Road Radio.
Hello.
Hello, you're on the air. You got to turn your TV down or turn your radio down. Hello, you're on the air. Okay, we're going to wait till bring them up. I think they had the...
Who was it? Was it David?
Why would you say that?
Why wouldn't I say it? You know why? Because I missed him.
Oh, good morning, God. David Struman, Motorcycle Safety Lawyers. Hey, David, what's going on? Yeah, I could hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, but you got to turn your stuff down so that you don't get reverb. Okay. He won't turn it down.
Yeah. You're fine.
Didn't
you
ever call into a radio station to win tickets? No, we're hearing you.
We're hearing you. You just can't be on the phone and have the radio station playing at the same
right.
time. Right. Okay.
David had a special announcement to make. Why don't we bring him back in a little bit? It was kind of like breaking news, bring him back type thing.
David is such a cool guy.
Okay.
And his brother both.
Yeah, they really are. They're great. What are you thinking? Okay. Can we go to the interview first? And we'll bring him back in a little bit? Yeah. It was kind of a breaking news special interview type thing. Well, it wasn't an interview, but just a quick breaking news. But hey, everybody, please like and share our page so that we can continue to bring these great interviews to you. And the next interview that we are bringing to you is the National Motorcycle Museum. My friend Jill Parham and Bill Barber are in the wings. And do we have those guys up? Okay. I know. I think David made us do some scurry stuff, but we'll get right back on that.
No problems.
Some scurry stuff. We do have them up. All right. And are they on Zoom, guys? We got them on Zoom? Okay. So Michael's bringing them up now. I should feel like I should.
Biker drop.
I should feel. I've got three engineers here this morning. And the screen still looks like this. They're doing so much. They're doing a lot of work around here as well. They've got a lot of things going on. We're doing so many upgrades on the towers and the radio show. No, we're not going to do David now. We're gonna hold off on him now. Okay, we have to hold off on that until after this interview because I don't want to keep them waiting. We've got the lovely Jill Parham with us and Bill Barber, and from the National Motorcycle Museum, one of my favorite places. I got to tell you. Jill, of course, is a 2019 inductee, the Sturgis Motorcycle Hall of Fame. She's the queen of the entire enterprise of J&P Cycles. Gosh, which they just brought up from the swap meets back in the day. I was so happy to work with Jill and John. Gosh, just years and years ago. Peatone and Chicago Swamp Meat. And gosh, she is also a Strider ambassador. So Jill, you have just done so many things for motorcyclists in motorcycling. You're an icon in the industry, and we're glad to have you. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Jaina. You're going to show our age by telling how long we've known each other.
I know. I didn't want to go there. But it's hard not to. We've had so many great, great years of motorcycling with you, with John, with J&P. I mean, J&P is a staple in the industry. So that's what's real exciting. Are we getting them on the screen as well? Is that what you're trying? Oh, she doesn't have video on?
No.
Oh, shoot.
I don't have video on.
You do have video on?
I don't have it on.
Oh, okay. So we can't see you. Shoot.
That's okay.
Hence, that's why I put a hat on this morning. I looked down and I went, oh my God, I can't do that. You would know what I mean. So, hey guys, tell us about, you guys had scheduled to open on the 14th and that didn't happen. They gave you a furlough of going further, right? So you had to... You had to reschedule your opening, but how exciting that you're going to be opening this month.
I know. We were supposed to open yesterday morning, but that didn't happen. But we have to obey the rules, you know, with the governor. So we're a nonprofit, and we certainly don't want to take any risk in losing that. And so we were all ready to open. We were so excited to see our customers. It's been 2.5 months now, and so... and it would have been great riding weather yesterday. Yeah. We had a great, beautiful day here in Iowa. And it's still nice here this morning, but we're going to get a little rain this afternoon. But we're excited still because we'll be opening on the 29th. And we surely wish that we could have opened for Memorial Day weekend, but it's not going to happen. So we'll be ready and so excited to see our customers on May 29th. We're excited.
Anybody that hasn't been
to the museum really needs to make a trip. Anybody who lives in the Midwest, it's a great trip there. It's easy to get to, and it's a great place to stay.
And get a hotel, because I'm telling you what, there's some great riding around that area as well, and right. It'll take you more than a day. I don't know. I've just never done looking at everything in that place. There's so much to offer.
There is. I'm a huge fan of Indian motorcycles, and you guys have that one prototype in there. Which I hadn't seen anywhere else. There's just a lot of great variety and a lot of historical pieces. I enjoyed it, nonetheless. What do I matter?
Well, you matter a lot.
Thank you.
But yeah, and Jill, how do you get those pieces? How do you get either contributors, or do you guys purchase different bikes? How do you get so much great motorcycle history?
Well, we're fortunate that we get...
Don't have.
alone here, and they'll tell me, you know, I got to pick that up. I sold it, but I'm going to bring you two more.
Oh, my God. So, yeah. So. Well, and I think that's, you know, just the passion that comes out of people, right? The passion, the loyalty of motorcycling, just, and that's got to be exciting when you get a call. Bring your motorcycle. Jill, I got to tell you, I love this picture that is going on the screen right now. I don't know what you're riding, a Honda, and it's you in some short shorts and a top, and you have short hair.
Wow, that looks like the Kawasaki 1000. What was that, Jill? That engine. Can we get that picture back up? That was a great picture.
That was a great picture. It'll just go in the roll. It'll just go in the roll. Okay. So we'll find out from Jill what that was. They can still hear us? Okay. Okay, guys, are you there?
Hello.
Yeah.
Are you there, Gina?
Yeah, we're here. Okay. We've got Randall in the studio connecting some wires. Or disconnecting some wires. Randall, what are you doing? Anyways, all is good, and we're still here.
Did we drop?
No, you guys are on. Okay, they can't hear us. All right. He's doing something. Anyways, the museum is in Animal Show, Iowa.
It is.
You want to get out there, and it is. There's some great roads out there
The state roads throughout Iowa, going north from Dubuque to Dodgeville, all within an area. I mean, we're talking about a 100-mile loop. It's a great day ride.
I do want to tell you, though, Iowa has some dark roads. So I was coming back from the storm the other night. I picked up Jake at Cedar Rapids. And those roads, their highways are even dark.
Yeah,
I noticed how bad my truck lights were because I was like, oh, my God. And there was one time that I started praying inside my truck.
We ran into a tornado once coming back. We're in the middle of nowhere. We pulled into some building, looked like a farmer's a shed, and the guy comes out. It was actually a shooting gallery. It was a gun store.
Oh, there you go.
It was in the middle of nowhere, surrounded by farms. It was the greatest place to keep the bikes. We spent a few hours shooting guns, and next thing you know, we're back on the road.
And Jill, how far is Jane P. Cycles retail from?
It's actually a mile north of here, is all.
Nice. Yeah, that's a great place as well. Got to go there. And we know that the rally will not be going on this year, or has it been rescheduled?
No, the rally is not going on this year, and neither is the vintage rally at the museum. We've actually decided for the safety of our customers that we won't have it this year.
Yeah, well, that's what you got to do, though. But you guys did have, you know, what I thought and was part of was the Cannonball. Was that last year or the year? No, that was the year before. You had the whole Cannonball crew come through there.
Yeah.
Had lunch for them. Yeah, I mean, what better place? Go to a motorcycle museum. But that's a great stop.
Cannonball is still on for this year so far.
So far.
Yeah. It's going from north to south this year rather than east to west.
Yeah. I kind of like when they traipse through the Midwest.
Well, they're going to be going through northwest Ohio, southwest Michigan, so it's not going to be that far of a drive to go see it.
Right.
Anyways.
Or ride.
That's for another show.
Yeah. Well, guys, we're really excited. I am thinking about taking a ride out for your opening. You're going to be coming.
That would be lovely.
Yeah, I really am. I'm thinking of taking a ride. So that's going to be Thursday, the
29th.
Is that a Thursday or Friday?
That is a Friday.
Okay, that's what I thought.
They won't let us open till midnight on the 28th. So.
Oh, there we go. You might have campers.
I know.
Well, guys, it's great to have you join us this morning. But please tell people where they can get more information to join your opening or any information about the National Motorcycle Museum.
They can either go to our Facebook page, Instagram, or actually to our website, nationalmcmuseum.org.
NationalMCMuseum.org. Check it out, guys, because it's definitely a destination ride. Got to get out there. And, guys, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
No problem. Thank you.
We look forward to seeing you very soon. And, yeah, Jill, I'll talk with you about that. We'd love to come out.
Okay, great.
All right, guys. Have a great weekend. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks.
You too.
Bye-bye. All right. There I just – and Jill Parham, she's just one of the neatest ladies. So – so graceful and so amazing to speak with. She really is great people. Hey, we want to say good morning to some folks. We want to say good morning to Scott. Good morning, Scott, Paul, Dan. Sorry, we've got a little bit of technical. They're upgrading and around here and
fixing a few of the bugs as those upgrades are taking place.
Yeah, well, you know, I think in technical terms, that can happen, right? But we've got some great people on. Skip Robinson, good morning, good morning. Please like and share. Please give our broadcast here a share. Share it to your page or to your friend's page. Share it to your writing, your motorcycle writing pages, please, and give it a like. Go on over to Open Road Radio, give that a like. You know, I could promote everybody else, but I don't promote I don't promote Open Road Radio so much. So if you would kindly go over to the Open Road Radio Facebook page, that would be fabulous if you could give it a like. I'd love to see a whole swell of likes today. Or you can give it a hate, but there's no hate button.
There's no.
Give it a like, give it a like, give it a like. We are going to run to a commercial break in 1 second, and I think we're going to come back with David. We're going to try to talk with him again, and then we've got a great interview coming up with Heartland Harley-Davidson featuring Bob Noll. We'll be right back after these messages.
Motorcycle accident? The experienced motorcycle accident lawyers will set your mind at ease so you can recover while they fight for your best possible outcome. Mark J. Schumann and Associates has over 30 years in personal injury and motorcycle accident representation and wins. Contact Mark J. Schumann and Associates at 833-IL-CYCLE. That's 833-IL-CYCLE. The Motorcycle Safety Lawyers or MotorcycleSafetyLawyers.com and speak directly with Mark about a free review of your insurance policy. No gimmicks, no scams, a free review. Sign up today for free to win a 2020 FXDR Harley-Davidson or $20,000 towards the motorcycle of your choice. And while you're there, you can also sign up for accident scene management classes sponsored by Mark J. Schumann and Associates. Mark J. Schumann and Associates at 833-IL-CYCLE, the Motorcycle Safety Lawyers.
Tired of aspirins, Tylenols, and ibuprofens for aches and pains? For the past 20 years, Chicago CBD and essential oils owner David Sachs has been involved in the specialty foods market, and seeing his customers' health challenges, his business has further evolved into providing direct wellness solutions. Bringing together a collection of the finest natural products from the hemp, essential oil, and honey worlds, David developed high-impact solutions people can benefit from. CBD isolate drops, sublingual, and broad-spectrum CBD and non-CBD raw honeys and bee products. Extra strength CBD pain creams, CBD bath products including shampoo, conditioner, Epsom salts, and bath bombs, and therapeutic grade essential oils. There's even CBD coffees, edibles like gummies and honey, and even CBD bacon flavored pet drops for your pups. Check out CBD bundles for additional savings by ordering online today at mychicagocbd.com. Use promo code OpenRoad15 for 15% off your order. And as David says, be well, stay well.
40 years ago, a biker dropped out of community college to follow his motorcycle dream. His name was John Parham, and he named his company J&P Cycles. Today, J&P Cycles is the largest seller of aftermarket parts, accessories, and gear in the world. It's the one-stop shop for motorcycle enthusiasts. Over 600 brands and 100,000 products all in one place. J&P Cycles Gold Club members enjoy free shipping on every order every day and 4% cash back on purchases. And nowhere else has certified motorcycle mechanics on call 7 days a week via chat and 800 number. J&P Cycles is a proud supporter of Open Road Radio. Visit us online at our legendary Anamosa, Iowa retail store, our Daytona Beach Superstore, and during the Black Hills Motorcycle Rally and many, many more events. J&P Cycles, riding, wrenching, racing since 1979.
We got Matt Swedlin. He was on with his father, Mark, a couple weeks ago. We've got Kristen. Good morning from Thailand. Thank you, Jim. We've got Polymaniac. Nice as always, special in this time. Something else than Corona. Thanks from Sweden. Thank you, Polly. Thanks so much. Marilyn Stemp. Hi, Matt. Hate that we're missing WWR this year. Oh, that was nice. She's got a little message thing going back and forth. Brady Brokowski. Good morning to you, the Jenkins. Good morning, Jenkins. David Sachs. Good morning to you, Dan Benson. Good morning. Thank you, everybody. And let me know if you are now hearing us. I think that, okay, everybody's cool. Everybody's got it. George, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Sean Winkler, Hokahei Rider, 887. Good morning. And Matt, great show. Thank you so much. Please give it a like and share, everybody. We're able to bring this to you because of our shares and because of our likes. Carolyn, good morning. Carolyn Thomas from Australia. I think that they are stuck there. They're stuck in Australia. They can't get out. Hey, you're leaving. You got no excuse. You get to leave. So let's go to the phone lines. I think we're going to bring David back now. Exactly. David, good morning. Can you hear us?
I can hear you fine. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Hey, what's going on, David? We got just a few minutes because, I think.
Good morning. Hello, Joel.
Good morning, my good friend. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you so much. So, Mark, my brother, Mark J. Schumann Associates, the motorcycle safety lawyer, loves working with Gina and Open Road Radio.
Thank you.
And we wanted to give her a surprise.
You
and
did.
So, I don't know, do you have my email?
I haven't been able to. Maybe the guys do. Randall, can you bring up whatever he's talking about?
I wasn't able to post it to the chat. It wouldn't let me.
So let's see if it. Randall says he's got something from you, and I don't know what it is yet. Barry Brown. Good morning, Barry Brown. All right. What is that, David? That looks like a billboard.
It looks like an advertisement pretty much for Motorcycle Safety Lawyers and Open Road Radio.
No way.
So, on 40 billboards throughout the city of Chicago. There you go.
Oh, my God.
So, you can send me an email at david@motorcyclesafetylawyers.com or chat to Gina and tells us where you saw it. You get a prize.
Oh, my God.
Motorcycle Safety Lawyers.
That is awesome.
Good,
so, it's a... Helping Injured Bikers. Helping Injured Bikers, MotorcycleSafetyLawyers.com. When did you guys do this?
Well, that particular billboard went up at 12:01 a.m. on Thursday and has run, all say, 40 different signs all over the city. It's been seen 100,000 times so far.
That's
oh
excellent.
Oh, my God. That is awesome. Listen, join us on Open Road Radio Saturday. Wow. Look at you guys.
This is really cool.
That is very cool. And just in time, it's Motorcycle Awareness Month. Great time to get out there and remind people to be careful. Watch out for motorcycles.
Indeed.
And we've got some great firms that lawyers that
sure.
help.
In the event,
I know
in
that
the,
yours does as well.
Yes, but nonetheless, in the event that, you know, a cager or a car somehow does something stupid, Mark J. Schumann has always had a great reputation and does a phenomenal job in supporting and representing motorcyclists. So he's really at the top here in Chicago as far as attorneys that understand the plight of a motorcyclist. So he's a good guy to have in your corner.
That's awesome, Joel. Thank you so much. And David, thank you so much. That is awesome looking. Okay, so
don't forget, because it's Michael's, go ahead.
What is your contest? If people see it on the road, just to let me know.
Either email me, david@motorcyclesafetylawyers.com, and tell me their name, address, and where. We will send them a fun surprise. And same thing, they can just chat you, whether it be on your page or on the Open Road Radio page or on the Choppertown broadcast, any way they want.
I just want to ride. I just want to ride as David's passenger. I just want to wrap my arms around his waist and
biggest,
just drive
me
into the sunset.
The largest passenger I ever had.
Oh my God, we're going to break this up. We're going to break you two up right now. Hey David, thank you so much. Hey, get on my chat either on Choppertown right here or on Gina Wood's Facebook page or Gina at Open Road Radio. Let me know if you see this sign anywhere. David, now I'm going to be searching the highways as I drive home.
Sounds good.
All right. Thank you so much. Woo! Look at that. All right. Thanks so much, David. All right. Let's get on with the show here. We are talking about preserving motorcycle history today. And one of the persons that I found out, this Bob Knoll that we're going to bring on in a minute, actually has a motorcycle in the National Motorcycle Museum and a lot of motorcycles in his own place because he owns Heartland Harley-Davidson in Iowa. So let's run to Iowa, back to Iowa right now and talk with Bob Knoll. Bob, welcome to the show. Okay.
Bobby. No, maybe not.
Okay. Well, gosh darn. Okay. So let's say good morning to some other people. Kelly, Catherine, thank you so much. Oh, and Kelly says hello to David Schumann as well. And also, I guess David just put up a contest. I wonder what they're giving away. Are you guys giving away a motorcycle? Yes, they are. They are giving away a motorcycle. So if you go to motorcyclesafetylawyers.com, you can check out that website and you can enter for free to win this FXDR 114.
It's a win-win.
Or $20,000 towards choice of your brand. How cool is that?
I just want to ride with David. That's all I want.
You're crazy. All right. We've got them back on the line. Good morning, Bob Knoll.
Hey,
how are you? Hey, how are you?
There?
Yep, sure are.
Are we there?
You are here. I don't see your video, but I got you by audio.
Hi, Joel.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning to you guys.
Indeed.
Hey, great to have you. You know, your name came up because Mark Mandurski said, well, you got to talk to David Knoll. Do you know Heartland Harley-Davidson? I said, you know, I know so many Harley-Davidsons across the country, and I don't have the pleasure of knowing Heartland, but I got to talk to Bob. Chicago native. I got to find out so much about him the other day. So, Bob, I'm really excited that you're joining us today. Thank you so much. And tell us a little bit about Heartland Harley-Davidson.
Well, thanks for having us, guys. We are just starting our 26th year as a family-owned and operated Harley-Davidson dealership here in Burlington, Iowa. We're very accessible. We really like working with Mark and Bill at the museum. And that's a wonderful, wonderful place.
Yeah, it is.
The bike that we have there is one of our backup bikes from our drag race team. We have racing bikes on display here. We are a full-service Harley-Davidson dealership, sales service, parts, finance, insurance, anything you want. And our setup today here is as a result of my son Craig sitting next to me here, who's the GM at the shop.
Good morning,
Craig. We kind of MacGyvered all the stuff that we have, that we're using, speakers and lights and iPads and all that stuff that I have no idea how it works.
Me and Bob were laughing about that the other day. We got to go find some 12-year-old, you know, walking down the street.
Get a 12-year-old kid. Exactly right, Gina.
Let's clarify that. We're looking for 12-year-old kids who have
a couple rallies. Craig knows Joel from his time at Moto Works in Chicago.
Indeed.
Craig went out into the industry and learned some things that I didn't know, and then came back about, 2 years ago now?
Yeah,
about two years ago and assumed the general manager's position here at the dealership. But like I said, we're starting the 26th year, family-owned, family-operated. We love our riders, and we love our sport.
That's awesome. And isn't it the coolest when you can work with family and do something that you love as well?
Well, it gives you the highest highs and some of the lowest lows.
And we don't kill each other.
That's
right?
Exactly right. Sometimes it's just best to walk away and shake your head and start fresh the next day.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's all fun, though. We have a good time.
Yep. We've got very similar interests. He was 11 years old when we opened this dealership. And so he's grown up around it and matured into a very capable manager.
That is awesome. And, you know, we're going to be, we had some technical difficulties early and brought you on a little bit later than we wanted to. So I would love to bring you guys back and talk more about your relationship with the National Motorcycle Museum.
Sure.
And some of the events. You guys are open, though, currently. Tell us about that, where people can find you, and a phone number as well.
Craig, go ahead.
Sure, yeah, we have our showroom open, and sorry, we had to flip to the dial in here. I think we were a little too far away from the iPad, so hopefully you can hear us all right.
But, we can hear you great.
Yeah, we did close down for about a month. We just did our service department and parts department, but we're back fully open. We're exercising social distancing and, you know, of course, being cognizant of the situation, but we're just glad to be open. I mean, I think, our riders and our customers and just everybody that comes in to see us is ecstatic because, like you guys, I think Illinois is a little more shut down than us, but, there's a huge ridership here in this area and there's actually some great riding here. So, we've had, I think everybody's very happy to just be back in the store around motorcycles and just, get things kicked off again. Cause I know everybody's got a cabin fever and just probably anxious to get something going this year. It's been tough.
Yeah, absolutely. So, and what a great destination ride for people to be able to come out to see you.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, we had a full calendar of events. We had to cancel a few, unfortunately, but, pending regulations and of course, just keeping in mind the situation that it is, we've got some bike nights and other things happening. So I think everybody's just anxious to get everything rolling. We've got about an acre parking lot and quite a presence here in the area. If you live in this area, we're on Highway 61. So bikes are riding by all day. I mean, we've probably had 50, 60 bikes come in just today, just to
nice.
Pull in and be able to go somewhere. Nice.
Craig, I'm going to stop by and visit this summer during one of my trips into Iowa. So
that'd be awesome. Hey guys, give us real quickly. Give us your website.
Yeah, we're only about,
give us your website.
3.5 hours from Chicago.
Great. Give us your website and we got to close it out, but we'd love to have you back.
Yeah. Thanks for having us guys. Come down. We've got about 50 bikes on display here. It's www.heartlandhd.com. That's heartlandhd.com. And check us out on Facebook. We're always posting up events and other things going on in the area. So,
great. All right. Well, you know what? It's been a great show. Had some great people on, and I think we're out of here. Go take a ride.
Indeed. That's maybe a little bit of day drinking.
Thank Let's you see. For if we go to Iowa or Wisconsin.
Yeah, or Indiana. I think we can.
Or Indiana. Thanks, Joel. Thanks for coming. It's always great to see my sidekick, Joel Cool, in the studio.
Indeed. The man who has a face made for radio.
Hey, have a great time on your trip. Let us know when you get back.
I will. I will. I'll tell you all about it.
All right. Sounds good, everybody. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for tuning in to America's premier motorcycle talk show. This is Carl King inviting you to join us again next week for another great ride with Open Road.